2018, August 11th. Today I want to talk about trade war, tariffs, subsidies and fines. I heard a certain economist and trader, which I do not want to advertise because he gives a bad service at an expensive price. So I will not advertise him, I will not say his name. But he said that tariffs are inflationary because they raise prices on the consumers. Well, they might raise taxes on the consumers. They may also not raise taxes on the consumers if the producers decide to lower their prices. But anyway, these things cancel each other. What matters is that tariffs are a tax, and as a tax they are deflationary because they reduce the amount of the currency of the government that applies the tax. So it is very clear that tariffs are deflationary. Now, subsidies, the reason for their enactment may be similar, not identical, but similar. They are intended to encourage production to encourage export, but they are inflationary because in the case of subsidies, they are when talking about whether something is inflationary or deflationary, it depends on the currency in which country is it inflationary, in which country is it deflationary. So to be more exact, tariffs might be tariffs are overall deflationary. As I said before, they might cause a rise in prices in the country that enacts the tariffs, but they also reduce its amount of currency that its non-government part has, because the government takes its own currency in the case of tariffs. In the country that exports to the country that enacted the tariffs, it may also be deflationary because it may cause its producers to reduce their prices, but it may also cause its government to increase its subsidies, and by doing so to cancel the deflationary effect in it. So again, these things cancel. Tariffs are deflationary for the country issuing the tariff, and may not matter for the exporting country that the tariffs are used against. And it may also be inflationary in an exporting country, but overall it is it depends on the country. It depends on whether the country is the one issuing the tariffs or the one suffering, if it is correct to even call it suffering. But this is a This is for another discussion, for the tariffs, from the tariffs. Subsidies, they are inflationary for the country that subsidizes its exports or its local products. Inflationary in this case, overall inflationary, because no currency is being taken in this case, taken by the government from the private sector. Again, opposite from tariffs, in which case there is a drain of the currency, a drain of a currency, which is why, again, tariffs are deflationary, subsidies are inflationary, fines are as a form of tax, like tariffs. Fines are also a part of a trade war, and are also overall deflationary. In a trade war, you have all of this, you have tariffs, you have subsidies, you have fines, and the subsidies have been in place for years now. The European Union subsidizes its exports. Fines. There were fines against Monsanto, against Bayer, against Deutsche Bank, against Volkswagen, against... There were also internal tariffs, ludicrous, tiny joke tariffs that the... Not tariffs, fines, that the United States government issued against General Motors. General Motors was responsible for death in accident. Intentionally, they abstained from fixing a defect in their cars just to save money. They paid the ridiculously low fines, and it still paid off for them to cause death, because fixing the problem would have costed them somewhat more. Anyway, this is it for today about tariffs, trade wars, fines, and subsidies.